Hello and welcome to Yojna's Candid Talk Show, where we engage in meaningful yet candid conversations with our esteemed guests. Today also, we will indulge in a candid talk, but on a very sensitive, debatable and controversial topic. What's going on in the world, in India in specific? For almost 15 months, the entire world is struggling with corona pandemic. More than 16 crore people have been infected so far out of whom more than 33 lakhs have unfortunately lost their lives. And we don't know when this all is going to end. Especially in the last 1 month, we all know the dreadful situation in India, and in some way or other, we all are suffering and struggling each day. But itne lambe samay aur is akalpaniya tabahi ke baad bhi ek prashn jo kai baar utha par har baar daba diya gaya aur wo aaj tak koi thos jawab hum logon ko nahi mil paya hai, wo fundamental question hai ki aakhir corona virus insano mein aaya kaise aur kahan se? Is it a natural calamity, a scientific disaster or a human generated well planned biological war that we are facing and living in today? So these are very big questions still unanswered, and to share his opinion on the same, we have a big name, a renowned army veteran who has always spoken up fearlessly on the most sensitive and debatable topics. Please welcome Major General Dr. Gagandeep Bakshi on this program to share his thoughts on this topic today. Welcome, Dr. Bakshi. Before posing any question to Dr. Bakshi, I want to pass on an important message that as part of corporate social responsibility, our company HealthPrax is offering COVID-related free medical consultation, psychological counseling and COVID yoga therapy. The helpline number is shared below and you can also find the details in the description box. So chalte hai Dr. Bakshi ke paas. Thank you so much, sir, for joining us today. So seedhe sawal pe aati hoon. COVID ke shuru hone ke piche bahut sari theories hain, jinme se lab leak ki theory pichle bahut samay se charcha mein rahi hai. आपको क्या लगता है कि ये COVID-19 एक नेचुरल डिजास्टर है, एक लैब लीक है या एक वेल प्लान्ड कॉन्स्पिरेसी? ओवर टू यू सर।
देखिए, जब ये कोरोना का बम हमारे सर पे पटा पिछले साल
जी,
और एक्चुअली पिछले साल ये शुरुआत हुई थी नवंबर दिसंबर में, रियली चीन वुहान के अंदर, तो उस वक्त जो कि लैंसेट जर्नल है, वेरी प्रेस्टीजियस जर्नल ऑफ यू नो मेडिकल साइंसेज, उसमें बहुत सारे जो टॉप वायरोलॉजिस्ट थे उन्होंने लिखा कि दिस इज अ नेचुरल एपिडेमिक, मैन मेड एपिडेमिक, इट हैज ज़ूनोटिक ओरिजिन्स और चाइना का कुछ नहीं इसमें नहीं। अब इसी चीज को बड़ी बारीकी से देखा जा रहा है, और जब देखा गया वो जो हेडिंग दैट लिस्ट ऑफ दोज टॉप एमिनेंट वायरोलॉजिस्ट वाज वन डॉक्टर पीटर दासजैक, इको हेल्थ अलायंस ऑफ द यूनाइटेड स्टेट्स, जिसको अमेरिकन नेशनल इंस्टीट्यूट ऑफ हेल्थ हेडेड बाय डॉक्टर फाउची, दे हैड फंडेड हिम to fund the Wuhan Institute of Virology to the extent of $3.7 billion for gain of function research on the bat coronavirus. Now, a word about the bat coronavirus and the Wuhan Institute of Virology would be very much in order. Yeah. You know who heads the Wuhan Institute of Virology? Two Chinese major generals, Xi Zhengli and Major General Chen Wei. ये top experts हैं virology के,
जी,
Chinese armed forces, top military experts. They are not civilian experts, they are not doctors from the medical fraternity, they are top military biological warfare experts. They are running the Wuhan Institute of Virology, right? So at that time, it was said this is a zoonotic natural epidemic. It has come from the Wuhan wet markets.
Yeah.
It now turns out that no bats are sold in the Wuhan wet market, whereas this disease came from the sledgehammer corona, the bat coronavirus, which these bats are found not in Wuhan wet market, but in Nanjing, 550 kilometers away. It also turns out that at that particular time, somewhere in fall of 2019, a Chinese team had gone from the Wuhan Institute of Virology to these bat caves, and when they came back, out of six, three died of some mysterious infection. Mm-hmm. There is also now much more information coming out, and I would refer you to the latest atomic bulletin of scientists.
Okay.
Very prestigious. There is no more prestigious scientific magazine.
Mm-hmm.
And Nicholas Wade has published a paper which questions the whole Lancet, you know, that certificate of good conduct that had been given to China earlier.
Yeah.
That Lancet papers led by Mr. Peter Daszak. Dr. Peter.
Yeah. And I would like to add here that this Lancet article came in early 2019 when this pandemic had just started. So there was not enough evidence actually to simply put down this theory that it is a lab leak or something intentionally done, thing.
Absolutely. And as more and more things have tumbled out of the closet, it is found that there was a conflict of interest. Mm-hmm. Peter Daszak was funding the same Wuhan lab. He was involved in those gain of function experiment. How can he give a clean chit? Then he is part of that WHO panel, which give another clean chit to China.
Exactly.
Because Tedros Saab is sold out to the Chinese. I mean, I'm saying it in so many words. And the WHO team, which went to China to investigate, it was quarantined for 15 days, confined to the hotel, while the Chinese washed clean, vacuumed the Wuhan Institute of Virology.
Mm-hmm.
They were allowed to go there just for three bloody hours. It was more of a tourism trip, right? And they were not allowed access to blood samples. They were not allowed access to waste water disposal samples. They were not allowed to interview any of the people working there in Wuhan Institute of Virology. All computer databases were shut down. They were not given access to any documentation. What do you take the world for?
Mm-hmm.
We may be fools, but we are not such bloody fools. You see?
Yeah.
You can't take the world for such an orchestrated ride. Now, you may or may not believe a military soldier, but it is my job as a national security expert, biological warfare very much comes in our domain.
Hmm.
The more we have studied this, the more evidence we have looked at, there is a great deal of overwhelming circumstantial evidence.
Yeah. You mentioned gain of function.
That this was not a naturally mutated virus. That this was a deliberate gain of function, souped up virus, genetically engineered in a laboratory, right? And we now have the American expert who helped Dr. Shi Zheng Li of the Wuhan Institute of Virology to do this experiment.
Yeah.
He guided them, actually. And the simple fact is that what this Dr. Shi Zheng Li had published four papers earlier, 2015 and thereabouts, where she had talked of splicing the SARS hook molecule onto the bat coronavirus. The Americans and the Chinese had done a joint study in 2018 where they had identified 89 species of bat coronavirus. Mm-hmm. The good news was that these had not made the jump from bat to human. SARS had made the jump from bat to human, but the intermediary was civet cats, a type of cats, Chinese, which the Chinese eat that kind of cat. So it was the civet cat which was the intermediary. This was found within, you know, weeks of the discovery of SARS. When the MERS, MERS, you know, virus started, then the intermediary animal was identified within 4 months as the camel to human, bat to civet to human. 15 months after the Wuhan outbreak,
yeah,
you still haven't got the intermediary animal because there is none.
Mm-hmm. One question here, sir. You mentioned gain of function. So I think it would be interesting for people, for a layman to know what the gain of function is. Do you want to throw some light on it?
Certainly, certainly. I think that's a very valid and relevant question. For the layman, what I would like to tell you is that in the United States, a whole lot of this so-called gain of function research was being done. What you do is you take the natural virus and you see how it could become more deadly. You know, if somehow a mutation takes place, how it could become more deadly. So you don't wait for that to happen. You get that thing in your lab, you genetically soup it up, you engineer it. Like in this case, the SARS corona hook molecule, the S protein molecule, that is the one that comes and hooks to your human cells. Okay, attaches to your human cells. Without that, the virus can do nothing to you. Unless it has got a hook molecule with the code to enter, permeate the walls of your cells. So what you do is you don't wait for nature to mutate. You do it in the lab so that you can discover the vaccine for it, the medicine for it and all that. Test it, try it out. You don't wait to be hit. You preempt.
Yeah.
You preempt nature.
Exactly.
The criticism is, this is highly dangerous. What if the Frankenstein that you have created gets loose?
Yeah, exactly.
That is precisely what is happened. The only thing we have to verify is, was that, what that Frankenstein getting loose, accidental, or was it deliberate part of biological warfare on the part of China?
Yes, absolutely. And I would like to add here that this gain of function research has been banned in many countries. And indeed, if I remember correctly from a research that during Obama time, it was banned in America. But then during Trump time, it was permitted again. And Dr. Shi Zhengli, along with a scientist from US and a team from US, they were doing these gain of function, this genetic engineering in simple terms, experiments in the Wuhan lab. So it has benefits that you understand the virus better so that you can, understand the ways to treat it going forward. But then as Dr. Bakshi said, that this is highly dangerous. There are highly potential risks involved in this research because of it. It is kind of banned. But still, it was happening in Wuhan, and this is a very big coincidence that at the same place the disease originated. So at this point, I would like to quote Dr. Shi Zhengli. You spoke about her. She's of course an internationally known virologist and bat woman. Yes.
No, so that's what she's called in China.
Yes. So पिछले साल जब ये lab leak theory ने सर उठाया था, तब एक Chinese social media platform है Weibo करके, उस पे उनका ये comment आया था. I would like to quote it as it is here. She wrote that the 2019 COVID is nature's punishment on the human race for uncivilized behavior. I swear on my own life that the virus has no connection with the laboratory. To those people who believe in and are spreading the rumors perpetrated by the third-rate media outlets, as well as believing in the unreliable academic analysis of Indian scholars, I would like to give this advice. Shut your dirty mouths. This is what she wrote. And of course, when it comes to persuading individuals with strong reasoning and developing confidence and trustworthiness, telling them to shut up is unproductive, isn't it? And in an ideal world, an independent party would have the last say on the matter. And as you said, in this case, she and the Wuhan lab had a clear conflict of interest. So any thoughts on this?
You are absolutely right. Let me just put it in perspective. Yes. This research was on in Obama's time, right? It was on in Obama's time. And then it was banned. You know, the Maryland University, virology laboratory in the United States, they did some tests and they found that there were dangers of leak and they were horrified. Mm-hmm. How you are going to create a disaster for us? Nature may not do that. You will. You know, so they banned that research. They stopped that research. All right? They stopped that research. That is the time, very cleverly, this whole gain of function lobby led by Fauci Saab himself, and then, you know, he outsourced it to Peter Daszak, who was heading their Eco Health Alliance, an NGO, and through that, the funding was continued. It was just transferred. This gain of function research was transferred to the Wuhan Institute of Virology.
Yeah.
Right?
Mm-hmm.
It was transferred to the Wuhan Institute of Virology. Now, let me give you, the fact that it is a genetically engineered virus, we have no doubt. I mean, after you read Nicholas Wade and the other very, very Nobel Prize winning science biologists have said, it's a smoking gun. It's a smoking gun. The moment you see the structure of this virus, the genetic sequence of this virus, it is plainly genetically engineered, and you know that they have a technique, you know, in which they call serial passage through cell culture. You know, so you don't do it in the petri dish, you do it serial passage through natural cell culture, so that it looks totally natural. That care has been taken to make it look like a natural virus when it is not.
Yeah.
Okay. This is extremely dangerous, as you very rightly said in your preamble. 166 million people have been infected.
Yeah.
Right? 3.5 million almost. Now the figure has gone up. I was just checking. Have died. $2 trillion hit to the global economy. Entire industries are flat. Have been ruined. The hospitality industry, the travel industry, even other industries have taken
exactly.
a knock.
Exactly.
I mean, it is the worst thing to have happened to the world after the Great Depression of the 1930s. And China, if this has, whether accidentally or deliberately, it has come from Wuhan. And the world has a right to know the origins of this. The American Senate is now investigating this. You see? And what had happened, unfortunately, was that when it started, the elections were on the fever pitch campaigning for the election in the United States. So at that time, Donald Trump and his team had said openly, this is the China virus and this is most likely a leak. But they said that maybe he's trying to divert attention, maybe from the problems at home, and therefore they will not allow him to get away with it. And therefore, a whole lot of this counter propaganda broadcast blasts were done at that stage, which have now found to be very, very motivated, very slanted, huge conflicts of interest. Now, let me slightly change the tax. Just permit me, because this is very interesting. Let me give you a few nuggets of information not generally known, right? In 1999,
Are these the evidences that have been collected?
Yes, evidences.
This theory surfaced in 2019 itself, as it started out only after a few months, but then it was set aside by the scientific community. It was whosoever raised it was considered as just doing a propaganda, whether it is Trump or anybody else. But now this year, again, these things are surfacing, these questions are coming up, and there is more evidence. Although WHO's team has recently cleared the lab, saying that, okay, nothing, it's not related.
I just told you how WHO team was treated. They were, for 15 days, they were put in quarantine.
Yeah.
Then they were permitted to go there for 3 hours. No blood samples, no wastage water samples, yeah. waste disposal samples, all computer networks were shut. No, they can't interview anybody. They can't go to the two critical hospitals where the first patients went. What inquiry?
Yeah.
Excuse me, what inquiry? And Tedros, you know, was overheard by some other people telling, we are here to help you. Give us a break. We are here to help you.
In this situation, how do you think, what could be the way for the truth to surface? What can be done now? Because anyways, people have doubts about even WHO playing this role of this, you know, investigating agency, because they have that conflict of interest.
You see, Tedros Saab was appointed with the help of China. He owes his position to China. There are a whole lot of other conflicts of interest. Half the vaccine, you know, patents are owned by somebody very senior in the United States, who was one of the first people to say, okay, this is not it. Right?
Yeah.
But what I am trying to tell you is, and this is something different, what I'm trying to tell you is that a country's official military doctrine cannot talk of biological warfare mm-hmm. when you have signed the convention for biological warfare, banning biological warfare.
Okay.
Right? China has signed that convention. Yet, in 1999, two Chinese senior colonels, Colonel Qiao Liang and Wang Xiangxi, they wrote a book called Unrestricted Warfare, in which they said, how will China deal with a stronger power like the United States? He says, have no rules.
Okay.
There are no rules in war. Terrorism, biological warfare, chemical warfare, radiological warfare, cyber warfare, information warfare, any and every type of weapon will be used. The aim is to win. By any means, fair or foul, military and non-military.
Mm-hmm.
This was said in 1999.
Okay, that's
subsequently, subsequently, in 2010, there was another book, War for Peace, by Guo Jiawei of the Chinese Army University.
Okay.
Who wrote a book on war for power, and he dealt with a concept of war with biological characteristics. How will war be fought with genetically engineered viruses?
Mm-hmm.
Right? Now okay. you can tell me, oh, these are private books. Yes, Chinese very senior officers have written them. But I mean, it's a private book. No? G.D. Bakshi can write a book. That's not official doctrine. Mm-hmm. Now let me give you the good news or the bad news. 2017, the People's Liberation Army of China has an official doctrinal document mm-hmm. called the Science of Military Strategy.
Okay.
So in 2017, they brought out a new version, a new edition. And in this new edition, they had added a chapter on biological warfare.
Okay.
Okay. They had added a chapter on biological warfare, on weaponizing the virus. Okay.
Mm-hmm.
This is 2017. Now let me give you another piece of, you know, insight. In 2015, the Chinese ordered a study on the SARS virus, and 18 scientists led by Xu Dezong of the Chinese Air Force, top scientist virologist of the Chinese Air Force, they mm-hmm. published 18 papers.
Okay.
And they said, the SARS virus is a biological warfare weapon. It has been used against China. So you understand what I'm saying?
Mm-hmm.
China believes, its top scientists believe, that China has already been attacked with biological warfare weapons.
Okay.
As far back as SARS, 2008 and all that, and now this study is done in 2015.
Mm-hmm.
And then these people made 24 presentations to the top Chinese leadership in the Central Military Commission. Let me just give you an excerpt of what they found.
Mm-hmm.
They said, or what they put across to their leadership. He said, there is a newfound ability to freeze dry microorganisms. And this has made it possible to store biological warfare agents and aerosolize them when you want to attack a target. Make them into, you know, freeze-dry, take it into some frozen food, go to the restaurant, kitchen, go to the bathroom, aerosolize them and just spread them loose. Nobody will be able to trace it back to you. And you will be able to overwhelm the medical system of the target country.
That's what is happening now. Yeah, exactly.
So you see, I am now saying, giving you, why should be the Chinese go mad and use biological warfare weapon? If they have a belief, these have been used against you.
Against them, yeah. Okay, so but sorry to interrupt you here, sir. So I will play devil's advocate here, considering that China was the first country that was, you know, that faced this dread of COVID pandemic at the very start. So why would China indulge in developing a virus and then infecting its own population with it?
Look, I hope you've read the nuclear doctrine of the United States. And India has copied parts of that doctrine. You know what that says? If any country uses nuclear, biological, chemical warfare against the United States reserves the right to retaliate with nuclear weapons. If a virus had spread, right? Mm-hmm. Only and only in the United States and India and China had been absolutely safe. Mm-hmm. There was a strong suspicion straight away that it is a biological warfare attack. Mm-hmm. So how do you mask it?
Yeah.
How do you mask it? You first prepare the antidote for this medicine for your own people, right? You prepare the antidote for this medicine for your own people. Let me give you a nugget of information. On 21st of January 2020, the Wuhan Institute of Virology filed a use patent for remdesivir for the treatment of COVID-19. So when you file a use patent ki this medicine works against COVID-19, you have to first test it. Test it two three months. Uske bagair to aapke bhi, you know, India made the vaccine. Wo vaccine, you know, we were told, oh, you haven't tested. How can 3 months, 4 months be enough?
Yeah.
Okay. So you have tested. The very minimum that you will test is for at least 1 month before you file a use patent for what? Remdesivir. You heard this name?
Yes.
Knows it now because it is one of the medicines in greatest demand for treatment of COVID-19, right? Yeah. They filed a use patent, which Wuhan Institute of Virology, in 21st January 20. So the earliest they could have known about, this virus as a dangerous virus was somewhere in December or November.
So this is an indirect evidence, but you're a very strong one, and you have put it forth in a very nice context.
You see, so what I'm trying to say is, one way to attack others and mask it is to say, oh my God. Now, whether it is actually accidentally escaped or it is a contrived accident, oh, it's leaked, right? And then the WHO joins in the act. They say it doesn't transmit from human to human. Till March 2020, WHO does not declare it an epidemic. Okay? And in all this time, Chinese PLA comes to sanitize the area around Wuhan. They are already ready for it. Right? If you know something you are going to release, then quite obviously you will have taken your precautions well in advance. So how come China had only 80,000, you know, total infected and just 4,000 killed? See the devastation in the United States. See the devastation in Italy. See the devastation in India, in Brazil.
Yeah.
Okay. So my point at issue is that if there is this kind of a theory that the Chinese suspected they are under biological attack. They were saying that in the military games in Wuhan, American Special Forces teams had come and released the biological warfare virus. So as far as the Chinese are concerned, they are retaliating. I have written a book where I have done a scenario gaming exercise.
Okay.
It's called Thunder Dragon, the COVID strike. I have gone into exactly how this kind of a thing could have happened as a scenario generation exercise. And then we have deliberately fictionalized it because some facts, so we are still waiting before we say it in so many words, and that will have to be at the international level. But kindly read that. And I've gone into the motivations, I've gone into the methodology, how it could have been done, how it could have happened, etc. But I am now giving you this, that either it is an accidental leak. In that case, China is guilty of covering it up till March. In February 2020, the Chinese Foreign Minister Chen Yi had asked all the neighboring countries of China not to close their borders for prestige reasons. And all this while, from the infected area of Wuhan, 25 flights a day were going to New York, were going to Italy, were going to Europe. It was very well connected. So infected people were going all over
the world. Absolutely.
So this is my answer to the skepticism that you expressed on me. This is how, is one scenario of how it could have happened. We wargamed that scenario.
Yeah. So what do you think should be done to bring the truth to the surface and establish the facts in this regard? Are you aware of any current, you know, new information in this area?
WHO has failed dismally. We either have to revamp the WHO to see that it has enough teeth. You have heard of an International Atomic Energy Agency, IAEA, that carries out inspections of nuclear plants in Iran, in Russia, in the other places. Because we've given it the teeth because it is so dangerous. This is equally dangerous. And now the UN will have to get together, the nations of the world will have to get together to enforce an inspection of all virological labs in the world. Because if they're going to be used for biological warfare, if they're going to be used to kill billions of people, because somebody has taken it in his head that the world's population is too much, you don't play God. We have lost our relations. We have lost near and dear ones. You want to play God? Who gave you that right? You want to reduce population? Reduce your bloody own. And as it is, they are now, you know, in serious problem because of the one-child policy. But what I'm trying to say is, China cannot be allowed to get away with it. Because if they have done it once and they feel they have gotten away with it, how will they be deterred from doing it again and again and again? India faced the first wave. We were able to contain it. We went into a hubris phase. We were ecstatic. Oh, we have won. We have won. And prematurely, we declared victory when we were hit by the second wave. Now we are trying to get the second wave. It's now getting under control. Started to come under control. Then we have news of a third wave. We deal with that. We'll have a fourth, fifth, sixth, tenth, hundredth wave. We just go on. It's some kind of a joke. The lives of your relations, my relations, matter for nothing. Somebody will just because people can't fight. They can't fight like soldiers. They haven't fought a war for 42 years, the People's Liberation Army of China. And the last war they fought, they were beaten.
The problem
they have one-child norm families. Those one child doesn't want to fight. His parents don't want him to die. So you're not prepared to fight the normal way, the decent way, face to face. You are such a Tarzan. Let's see you fight. But you want to fight this way?
You are very much convinced that this is definitely a man-made virus. And now there can be two possibilities. One is it was lab leaked. That is the most widely accepted theory as of now, not established, of course, and kind of cleared by the independent agency driven by World Health Organization. And the
World Health Organization is the last one from which you would expect any measure of objectivity. We've told you
that's a separate. Yeah, that's a separate big debate in itself, and we are not the right authority. But what I want to ask you is that out of these two things, whether it is a lab leak theory is more
currently,
or the other one that is a deliberately done attempt. What do you think? And if it is, the worry is that if it is a well-planned conspiracy by China, then what do you foresee happening next?
Okay, you see, my point at issue is that as of now, the bulk of the professional experience in the world is veering from the natural epidemic. It has veered to the lab leak theory. But there is still a strong suspicion which cannot be ruled out unless we have very empirical evidence to the contrary, that which cannot be ruled out. That is the deliberate release theory also, because of the fact that if the Chinese think they have been victims of biological warfare, in their mind the justification exists for using biological warfare to attack. They may justify that they are just defending.
Yeah.
So that's number one.
So
that's
what can happen next then? What would be the next step?
The next step should be that the world has to come together. We cannot stand this nonsense forever and ever. Why we are very suspicious in India is when the second wave came, it came to South Asia. It hit only India, not Pakistan, not Bangladesh, not Nepal, not Sri Lanka, not Myanmar, not any other South Asian nation. Does the virus know boundaries? Or does it carry passports? I'm just asking you.
Yeah.
If the region that is getting infected, you are trying to tell me that there is far greater masking and control in Pakistan. You see? So, the first virus, that first wave that hit India was not very lethal. The morbidity was not very high.
Yeah.
Casualties were not so much. The second wave, and you know these viruses can be genetically engineered to target particular ethnic groups. I hope you know that.
They can be. Yeah, I'm a scientist by profession. So yes, I do. Do you think, and I want to ask you, actually not putting forth my opinion, the Indian government, the way the second wave was handled, because with the first one, we probably were lucky that it went by without causing much damage. But the second wave, when the entire world knew that the second wave and the third wave, it is, and the corona is not yet over. And I'm living in Germany. We are kind of in restrictions for last 1.5 years, and it is yet there. In India, we became so lenient before it was over. How do you think the government handled? And do you think that गवर्नमेंट से कहीं कहीं चूक हुई या क्या परेशानियां हुई, क्या ऐसा हुआ कि हमें, हम हीरो से 2020 में हम हीरो थे और 2021 में हम जीरो हो गए? सो आपको क्या लगता है ऐसा क्यों हुआ?
देखिए, ऐसा है दैट मेरी सोच में हमें ह्यूब्रिस आ गई. यू अंडरस्टैंड ह्यूब्रिस की वी हैव वन, वी वन. I hope you remember that in March 2020, India had enforced the strictest lockdown in the world.
Yes, that's true.
Every train was frozen. Every air movement, road movement across the country was frozen. Yeah. And we had only 500 infected cases. And then we were told, Mar diya, look at the Indian government, how strict they are being. Bichare migrant labor ko marwa diya, isko marwa diya, usko marwa diya. You know, whole lot of criticism that we have been too strict, too harsh in our anti-COVID measures drive. We've been too harsh. We contained it, right? So there was an element of COVID fatigue. Not yes. even in China was a nationwide lockdown ever put. They just contained by Wuhan. Hmm. It never went to Beijing. It never went to Shanghai.
Yes, that's pretty interesting, isn't it?
Shanghai is about 800 kilometers. Beijing is about 1,000 kilometers. It reached, you know, New York. It reached Rome. It reached India. But it never reached Shanghai and Beijing. That is the point that I'm trying to make. There is something that is very, very suspicious.
Yeah.
Too much of circumstantial evidence which leads to very disturbing conclusion. Now, you were talking about what happened in India. Of course, we were taken by surprise. We should not have, but we were taken by surprise. And even the United States last year was overwhelmed. Yeah. I hope you know that their dead bodies are still lying in refrigerated trucks. They have not been buried. You know, so it's very fashionable to kick a third world country black and blue. Oh, these sucker Indians. Don't forget, we are the vaccine capital of the world. We've dished out so many free vaccines instead of making a profit like a lot of others are doing. Profiteering. We've been giving free vaccines to the poor countries around our neighborhood and other places. So yes, of course we goofed up. You should be able to admit that you went wrong. Of course we goofed up. We paid a price for it. But we are now on the recovery. Conclusion. I would like to state that at the time this virus exploded on the world, there was a massive cover-up operation. There was an indecent haste to give China certificates of good conduct and certify that this was a natural zoonotic virus. 15 months down the line, we still haven't found the intermediary animal vector. 15 months down the line.
Yes.
You know, and more evidence has come up that the people who wrote the initial Lancet article had conflict of interest. They were funding the Wuhan Institute of Virology for gain of function research, which has gone horribly wrong. Now, whether it went horribly wrong because of accidental factor or deliberate factors, that is what has to be determined. And I'm afraid the Chinese will not admit to it. It is the intelligence agencies of the United States and some other advanced countries which can possibly get to this truth. Will possibly get to this truth.
Yeah.
There have been some defections already, and one Chinese doctor has been on American and Indian television. Maybe there will be more, but we can get to the bottom of it. You know, China can't do genocide on this scale. Don't forget, Adolf Hitler gassed 6 million Jews. He had huge stockpiles of chemical and biological warfare there. The war was fought till the Wolfschanze, the Führer's bunker in Berlin. But even a fiend like Hitler never used biological warfare weapons because he knew he would get retaliation in kind. Now, China seems to be convinced that it will not be retaliated against, and therefore it can keep infecting the world, keep raising its economy and torpedoing the economy, the United States, India, Japan, all other countries of the world, destroy our medical systems, force them to collapse. Well, if that is the intention, it cannot be allowed to pass. And even if it is accidental, China is responsible. I hope you know that in the United States, Larry Clement, one of the top lawyers, has filed a $20 trillion suit by name against Dr. Major General Xi Zhengli and Major General Chen Wei, the heads of the Wuhan Institute of Virology. I hope you know. Thank you.
Thank you so much. Thanks. Thanks a lot, sir. हर बार की तरह आपने पूरे जोश के साथ बहुत अच्छी रिसर्च के बेसिस पे आपने हमारे साथ अपने विचार शेयर किए. उम्मीद है कि जल्द ही सच्चाई दुनिया के सामने सबूतों के साथ आएगी. थैंक यू सो मच फॉर जॉइनिंग अस टुडे.
थैंक यू.
तो हमने आज डॉक्टर बख्शी को सुना. हम किसी भी थ्योरी का कंक्लूजन निकालने या जजमेंट देने वाली अथॉरिटी नहीं है, बट डेफिनेटली आज हमने एक सीनियर सिक्योरिटी एक्सपर्ट को सुना. तो ऑल इन ऑल इस मामले को दबने नहीं देना चाहिए. एक और इंडिपेंडेंट जांच होनी चाहिए, पर WHO नहीं बल्कि किसी और मजबूत इंडिपेंडेंट ग्लोबल संस्था के माध्यम से. और जो जो पॉइंट्स आज डॉक्टर बख्शी ने हमारे साथ शेयर किए, मैं उम्मीद करती हूँ कि ग्लोबल लेवल पे उस तरह के कुछ डेवलपमेंट्स जल्द ही होंगे और उसका हमें रिजल्ट देखने को मिलेगा. So thanks to all the viewers watching the show, and please follow COVID appropriate behavior. Stay home, stay safe, take care. See you soon again on Yojna's Candid Talk Show. Thank you very much. Have a nice day.